Welcome user, in the last video we have seen operations on categorical data. We have seen how to identify and replace non-relevant entry from dataset. Also we have seen how we encode categorical data. In this video we are going to see information about feature scaling. So let us begin. We know that if our data is clean, we will make optimized machine learning model. And till now we have followed so many operations on data to make data clean. Feature scaling is one of the steps we have to follow to make data well. Let us understand feature scaling concept by considering car dataset. Over here you can see imported dataset. You can see total 5 features. Out of 5 features, MPG is dependent feature and remaining 4 are independent features. All features are continuous numerical, so we can make regression model which will predict mileage of car. So basically we will make equation which would be combination of dependent variables and that will predict independent feature, that is mileage. If we look dependent features carefully, all features have the different range of magnitude and unit of measurement. So if we make model by considering dependent variables and if those all dependent variables have different scale, then our model will show inaccuracy while predicting independent variable. So with the help of feature scaling, we can avoid measurement and scaling problems of dependent variables. With the help of feature scaling, we can convert all input features into one scale. There are so many methods of scaling, but more widely used methods are standardization, also called as an Z-score normalization, and normalization, also called as an min-max normalization. There is no thumb rule for selecting method, but generally we choose method depending on type of data. If observations from features are continuous numerical type, then we use standardization. If observations from features are continuous numerical type and continuous discrete type, then we use normalization. And also we can decide the method on the basis of algorithm by considering Euclidean distance concept. Over here you can see with the help of standardization, we can map data based on standard normal distribution. And if we calculate mean and standard deviation of scale data, we will get values 0 and 1 respectively. Over here you can see standard normal distributed data. By using Z-score formula, we can convert data from normal distribution to standard normal distribution. In the formula, Z is nothing but scaled observation, X is nothing but observations from feature, mu is nothing but mean of that feature, and sigma is nothing but standard deviation of that feature. Now let us discuss about the second method, that is normalization or min-max scalar. With the help of normalization formula, we can convert data between 0 to 1 value. In the formula, xi is nothing but observations from feature, x minimum is nothing but minimum value from that feature, x max is nothing but maximum value from that feature. So let us implement both methods in MATLAB. Over here you can see the code. Assume that I have applied all previous data preparation steps, like I have replaced missing values and outliers. And now I can apply standardization to input feature. First I have saved car data into variable A, so now I can perform operations on data and original data from car file would not change. Right here you can see same formula of standardization in code format for each independent variable. If I run the code and check the final data, we can note difference by looking into MATLAB output and by looking into Excel sheet of original data. You can conclude input variables are scaled. We haven't applied standardization to output feature. Do remember, we don't apply any data preparation method to output feature while modeling. So I have considered only input features for the operation. Now let us see normalization. Over here I have implemented normalization formula on original dataset. If I run the code and check the output, now again note the difference by looking into MATLAB output and by looking into Excel sheet of original data. You can conclude data is scaled. So this is all about feature scaling. In this lesson, we have seen different techniques of feature scaling. This will end our lesson and second chapter. In the next chapter, we are going to see how we perform different techniques of transformation and feature selection. Thank you for watching this video. Do like this video if you found it helpful. If you have any queries, post them in the comments and get in touch with us. Follow us on LinkedIn, Facebook, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Education is our future. MATLAB is our feature. Happy MATLABing.